Hello and welcome to case studies section on filter function. In previous videos, we have understood some of the limitations of second argument of filter inside calculate function. Then we have understood that using filter function, we can overcome this limitation. We have then also understood about the syntax of filter function, some of its other characteristics and how it works in the background. Now in this video, we will look at one case study where calculate function will need to take help of filter function. So here is the question which we need to answer based on the dataset inside our data models. We need to count the number of customers to whom the sales were made above $1,000. This seems to be a straightforward and relevant question for any of the businesses. All of the businesses are really keen to understand who are their high value customers. So we need to get an output something like this inside our data models. So here you can see that for each of the calendar years, we have the distinct count of customers and how many of them are high value customers where the sales was made above $1,000. So let us get started and see this how we can create inside Power BI Desktop. Now the first step would be to create a matrix visual. So let us put calendar year inside row area of this matrix visual and then quickly format the row headers, column headers and values font size. Now the next step would be to create two DAX measures. The first one will be for gross total sales value and counting the dim count of customers or distinct count of customers. So if you have been following this course, we have already created these two DAX measures. So here you can see that this is for distinct count of customers and second one is for gross sales value. So if you have not created this DAX functions earlier, just look at the DAX function which we have entered here and create them. So this is for counting the distinct count of customers and this will be for the gross sales value. So you can create this very quickly on your own now. And now the next step would be to count the customers to whom the sales was made above $1,000. So let us select sales table, right click and create a new measure. So let us give this measure a name which will be high value customers equal to and let us start typing calculate. Now in the first argument, we will be specifying distinct count of customers, which is the DAX measure we have already created up for counting the customers. Then the second argument will be for gross total sales value greater than or equal to 10,000 now or 1,000 sorry. And now here you can see that I have referred to a DAX measure inside filter argument of calculate. So let us press enter and see whether we will be getting the result. So this is the error which you will get if you are specifying any measures with the filter conditions under filter argument of calculate. You can't simply specify any of the measures under this filter argument. So we need to encode filter function to get this results. So let us start typing filter. And now second argument of filter function will be the same one only. However, now here in the first argument, we need to see which table we have to refer to. So if I refer a sales table here and let us see whether I will be getting the results and let us press enter. Now you can see that I am not getting an error. So I'm assuming it is working. So let us put this in our matrix visual and see what results we are getting. Now here you can see that we are getting the results over here, which is like 900 for 2001, 2002 is 2276 and 3 and 4. So you may assume that we are getting the correct results. However, this is incorrect result because in first argument of filter condition, we have specified sales table and it will iterate on each of the row of the sales table. So it is iterating on the each of the sales order and not at the customers level. Since one customer can have multiple orders in a particular year and if those are below 1000, it won't get counted. However, if total for the year is more than 1000, it should have been counted at the customers level. So we will need to specify customers table in this first argument, since it will iterate over each of the customers row from the customers table. So let us press enter and see the results which we are getting. Now immediately you can see that we are getting a little higher number compared to previous one. Now let us quickly understand what is really happening in the background to get this result with the four-step process which we have seen for calculate function. So the first step would be to get the filter context from the initial filter visuals. So the initial filter context is for the calendar year. Then the second step would be to check the filter context provided by the calculate function. Now here you can see that we have used filter function, and within that we have specified our filtering conditions. So here you can see that this gross total sales value will be getting calculated on each of the customers under customers table for this, and then it will evaluate whether that total sales value for each of the customers is more than 1000. If it is more than 1000, that customer row will be kept, otherwise it will be removed. So this is happening everything in the background. So there will be a virtual table which will be created for the customers for each of the calendar year and will be calculated based on the gross total sales value. And then it will be passed on to the sales table, and it will filter out the relevant rows, and the number of customers are being counted over here. So I hope it is now clear to you how this filter function works. One of the important thing to remember here is that filter function will iterate over the customers table, since we have mentioned that in our first argument. If we specify the sales table, it will iterate over the sales table, which will be at the sales order level and which we don't want. So you should always specify the correct table in first parameter or first argument of filter function. We will see more examples using this function in later part of the course. So that is it from my side, guys. See you guys in next video to understand all family of DAX functions. See you guys.